Well, Maddie just called me and she said she needs a ride to the coffee shop. Oh, Maddie.
How's it going?
Going well. Get on in.
Thanks.
You need a little study break?
Of course. Just have to escape my dorm.
I bet. We all need to get away sometimes.
Yeah.
Gotta get your study on. Put that seatbelt on. Safety first.
Of course.
How has freshman life been moving to LA from Texas?
It's actually been kind of crazy. Not gonna lie, the first 3 weeks were really stressful.
So you just moved from Dallas to Los Angeles, right?
I like being kind of away from like big, large crowds and just kind of like, I love having my alone time. So that is a big change coming to LA because I've noticed there are just like so many people everywhere you go. The traffic is crazy here.
Right, and it's go, go, go all the time.
Yeah, it's very different. Because like when my schedule was training for the Olympics, mainly everything outside of the gym was just like for recovery. Now like not only do we have classes, but we have like freshman study hall and just like you have to find time to do your homework and study on your own. The first, I guess, 3 weeks or like month were pretty hard to balance.
I'm sure it was quite a whirlwind after Rio.
Yeah, I didn't expect like all this stuff after, like all the media and everything after I got back from the Olympics. I just thought like, oh, I'd come back and have like a couple weeks to myself to like relax and get ready for college.
Sure.
And then I was like constantly doing something like every day. And then I literally came out to school the day before school started.
Oh my gosh. Well, what kind of fun things did you get to do? I saw on Twitter a couple things. You were at the Rangers game.
That was my favorite, I think. Yeah, that was probably my favorite because I've always wanted to throw out the first pitch for the Texas Rangers.
Oh,
so
perfect.
I got to meet like all the players and the coaches before the game and go in like their dugout. And
I think you went to a concert or two.
Maybe.
So what, I mean, did you get to see Carrie?
Yes.
Is that so cool or what?
I always wanted to meet her, and then I got invited by her to present her the CMT Artist of the Year. So not only did I get to meet her, we got to sit, Allie and I got to sit with her at her table like the whole night, her and her husband, while she accepted the Artist of the Year award for the CMTs.
That's amazing.
It was so much fun.
It's amazing. So like, what'd you guys talk about?
Just everything. Yeah. I mean, she wanted to know like kind of what we did before, like while training for the Olympics. Yeah. And then
did you give her some exercises to do?
Allie was coming up with a couple, but
can you imagine her doing be like, yeah, do a couple Kip Cast handstands.
Yeah,
you
know? Just a bar conditioning set.
Yeah, seriously. I mean, you could teach her a thing or two, I think. But what did that feel like when she tweeted you?
I just like jumped out of bed and like started screaming, and I ran into our little like kitchen area and like our little living room where the other girls were, and they started screaming for me too because they were so excited.
That's
that
so
finally awesome. Like my biggest like girl crush and like my favorite artist tweeted me.
Heck yeah. Well, you went from pumped that she tweeted you to sitting at dinner with her.
I guess I never really thought that one day I'd be spending like a night with Carrie Underwood. I just wanted to meet her.
Totally. That's so fun. Okay, well, I think that we need to do a Carrie Underwood shout out.
Okay.
Does that sound good?
Yeah. Okay.
Carrie Underwood is definitely a moment for you in the Olympics. Were there any other special moments at the Olympics that you'll are just like unforgettable for you?
For sure. You know, I think one of the biggest moments that I was super surprised about was when Hoda from the Today Show, she surprised us with Zac Efron.
No way.
Yeah. Wow. So we got to meet him and like talked to him for like a long time too. He was really nice. I was surprised that he said he was more nervous to meet us than we were like freaking out that he was like in the same room as us. So like, yeah, it was genuinely a nice guy.
I love that. On that note, I feel like we need to give him a little shout out.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, well, this one's for Troy.
Soaring, flying, there's not a star in heaven that we can't reach.
If
we're trying, so we're breaking free.
We're breaking free.
Speaking of soaring and flying, you do just that on bars.
Thanks.
I think the whole country knows that there is no bars quite like Madison Kocian bars.
Aw, thanks, Corey.
I've been watching your bars in the gym recently, and we're seeing something quite similar to what I saw in Rio.
I'm actually pretty excited. You know, the level of gymnastics will decrease a little bit, although I'm trying to keep some of my skills on bars and some unique stuff.
It doesn't look like you're decreasing much.
Well, I'm trying to keep some unique stuff because I don't want the level of college gymnastics to like slowly decrease into something really easy. I want to like keep it at a higher standard, but I'm really excited actually competing more than just like a couple times like a year.
Right. Are we gonna see you on floor?
Yes, I'm very excited.
Yeah, so like what kind of vibe do we have on your floor routine? Is it similar to your elite routine or is it like totally different?
Oh no, totally different. For me, especially learning at the beginning, a lot of the dance moves and like just getting my body to move differently was hard, but yeah. I'm really enjoying, especially having three passes and just having a little bit more fun on the floor and like being able to smile and just, I don't know, have more fun.
It looks like you're having fun on the floor. Yeah. I mean, what was it like working with Miss Val, choreographing your floor routine?
I can't believe the way she choreographs. Like, she comes into the gym one day, I get there a little bit early before practice starts, and I just see all these notes, and it's like 1, 2, 5, 7. I'm like, how does she even read this? Like, what does that even mean? But I mean, her routine, her style comes together.
It comes together, and it's amazing. Is there any way that we can maybe see a sneak preview of your floor routine?
Yeah, for sure.
We're gonna play rapid fire questions. So I'm gonna either say a word or a phrase, and you have to say the first thing that comes to your mind as quick as you can. Miss Val.
Funny.
Dodgers.
Baseball. Ew. No, I like baseball, not the Dodgers.
Right, okay, good. Dallas.
Home.
Rio.
Adventure of a lifetime.
Whoa.
That was more than one word.
That's deep, that's deep. Gold.
Hard work.
Carrie.
Carrie Underwood? Girl crush.
Girl crush. UCLA.
Bruin family.
Aww, that's the perfect one to end on.
I want to buy that house right there.
Would you exchange your medals to buy a house?
No, never, never. I didn't even bring my medals out here because I was like, if something happens to them.
Right. If Miss Val steals them.
She has Kyla's right now.
I know.
Kyla's not getting it out of that safe.
No. She told me today that she's gonna come in the gym one day and just be wearing her medal.
Oh, okay.
So you could have gotten in that trap too.
Oh no, I would have never gotten it back.
Yeah.
This has been a fun ride.
It has been a fun ride. Okay, you're gonna get a lot done at the coffee shop right now. Be productive.
I will, Corey.
Call me if you need a ride home.
Aw, thanks for the ride, Corey.
You bet. See you later, Maddie.
I'll see you in the gym.
See you in the gym.